3, 2, 1.
Hello guys, it's your boy Ismail. We're about to do some... Alright, let's move on.
We lower the stakes by having a playful approach to any activity where the student has to speak. Because the goal is for them to use their English language as much as possible and as best as they can, and not perfectly. So one of the biggest challenges I think I have with the older students is them being very aware of what perfect English is, because a lot of the things that they consume in regards of entertainment is in English. So it can be very hard to express yourself in an English class because there are others watching and listening. I'm trying to dissolve some of that insecurity and make lessons that are also relevant to them by being playful and also by being something from their own world.
When do you think it is okay to call out bad behavior in actions or speech?
My main objective was to work with the term cancel culture and to have students discuss their own opinions. The warm-up exercise, we played what we call a flip-flapper in Danish. Is it a fortune teller, maybe, in English? Yeah. And in taking something that's from their childhood, I was trying to kind of, lower, the floor with the first exercise that we did of the day.
Talk with a partner, and they choose a color, and then you have to spell the color. So green, G-R-E-E-N.
So the paper had different colors on it. And then they could choose a number and choose a number again, and there would be a question behind that number. So it could be, what do you think culture is? Or have you ever known of somebody who has been cancelled? Or do you have an idol who is a celebrity? It could also be a question where they ask each other how they're doing this morning. They all have to do with either themselves or, the topic cancel culture.
It's usually not something that we use in class, but more like something that you play with when you're younger. I think it's just a fun way to do something that otherwise would have just been like on paper and just written down.
It's a bit more approachable than getting a list of questions to ask each other. Then we moved in to defining terms.
So now you're going to work with some terms.
They had 9 terms that they had to explain by writing just a short phrase. So it could be political correctness, or it could be censorship. The goal was for them, of course, to explain it and understand it themselves, but also for them to afterwards draw. So I asked them to draw a term and then show it to another student, and the other person had to guess.
Publicity.
Yeah, publicity.
I believe that for my subject, it helps when the students are being social. They were laughing a lot. A lot of them also joked a bit with what they could draw, and that creates joy kind of in the classroom. I tried to create a room where they all feel safe enough to make mistakes, and none of them can draw perfectly. So when we started with that, everything else that happens afterwards kind of is influenced by that. So after the break, the students were given a task. Each group got a role that they had to play. The first scenario, they were a gamer that likes to play online games. The second scenario was them being a beauty influencer. And then in the last scenario, they were supposed to be a comedian. All groups were asked to create videos.
You're also allowed to have props for your videos.
For us to be able to have space, we went up to our play space. So that's kind of the best place to go if you want to be creative.
A lot of people like to be up here where we can go into this room and be here and do all this kind of stuff. I just get happy by it. I feel like a kid again.
So they could use anything they wanted in the room as a prop or as a background in the video. The students always are in a frenzy in the beginning because there's so much stuff in here that they can touch and use. That's an indication of them being engaged in the lesson and actually having fun with it.
To start this channel off, we're going to be going on a room tour.
They were asked to film their videos. Then all groups were
canceled because of something that they have done or made. So they got a paper with some comments. So first they had to react to those comments by either making a video or making a post, and then they had to discuss what it felt like being canceled and getting those comments. I would like to create moments in my lessons where the students can laugh, where they can play a bit with the language too. It's also the students' responsibility. We have some expectations of them to help us create these joyful moments in these joyful classrooms.
Moisturizer. Huh? Very nice.